numbers. So here we are having many different types of number systems like binary, decimal, octal, and hexadecimal. So these are four different types of number systems we are available. So for the conversion of these things, now we discuss how to convert these number systems into one of the four: binary to decimal, decimal to octal, and octal to hexadecimal. So for this purpose, firstly we have to know what is the conversion. So here we are using 8421 conversion. This is nothing but BCD conversion. BCD conversion is nothing but first numbers you should take like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. These are the numbers which we are going. Then we are converting these numbers into BCD format. Then first 0, we are calling 0, 0, 0, all will be 0. So 1, it will be 0, 0, 0, 1. For 2, 0, 0, 1, 0. For 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. 4, 0, 1, 0, 0. But from 5 onwards, we should see where the two numbers we should be counting. Like 5, 0, 1, 0, and 1. Means 4 plus 1 will be 5. That's why we are keeping 1 at the position of 4 and 1 at the position of 1. Then for 6 also, in the same way, we have to keep 0, 1, 1, 0. For 7, 0, 1, 1, 1. For 8, the 8 number. We should check the number 8. Here, there we should keep 1, 0, 0, and 0. For 9, 1, 0, 0, 1. For 10, we should add these two. 8 plus 2 will be 10. So 1, 0, 1, 0. For 11, 1, 0, 1, 1. For 12, 1, 1, 0, 0. For 13, 1, 0, 1, 1. For 14, 8 plus 4, 12 plus 1, 14. 8 plus 4, 12, 13, 14, and 0. For 15, all will be 1. So these numbers are nothing but whatever numbers we are knowing. So this is the BCD format of these numbers. So from 0 to 9, these we are saying it as normal number system. But from 10 to 15, these are called as hexadecimal. Hexadecimal, here we are defining each and every number with a alphabetical code. 10 will be A, 11 will be B, 12 will be C, 13 will be D, 14 will be E, and 15 will be F. So this is the BCD format of the number system for conversion of any number. See, suppose if we are converting number 2, number 2 we are saying it as a binary format like 0, 1, 0. For number 4, it will be 1, 0, 0. For number 6, it will be 0, 1, 1, 0. So just we check how to convert binary to decimal and decimal to binary the same way, how these conversions will occur, and decimal to octal, and again octal to decimal, octal to hexadecimal, and hexadecimal to octal. How these conversions will be done? So first we'll check for any binary number. I'm taking any binary number to octal. So here binary number, I'm taking 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 0. So this is a binary number which we are denoting with base 2, and octal will be defined with the base 8. So now I should convert binary into octal numbers. So for binary conversion, for the base 8, we should divide it into 3 parts. So this will be, from coming to the right side part, we should convert into 3 slots. This slot will be 1, this slot will be 2, this slot will be 3. So we should check 1, 0, 0. Where will be 1, 0, 0? Here 1, 0, 0 lies in this way. That means the 4 can be said as 1, 0, 0. So we are keeping here as 4. Then 1, 1, 1. What will be 1, 1, 1? 1, 1, 1 will be 7. So here it will be 7. Then 0, 1, 0. Where in 0, 1, 0? The number 2 we are representing as 0, 1, 0. So number 2. Like this, we should convert it into the base 8. This is a conversion of binary to octal. In the same way, we'll check for octal to binary. So octal here is the base 8. Here we are converting 8 to binary 2. So we can take any number like 621. 621 is a number with the base 8. This we have to convert into binary number. So we should check what is the number of 6, what is the binary code of 6, 100. So 6 will be 110 and the 2 will be 010 and the 1 will be 001. This is a binary representation of a decimal octal to binary. So this is nothing but binary to octal and octal to binary. This is one conversion. We have done from binary to octal as well as the octal to binary. Next we check for another conversion, that is for binary to decimal. Binary to decimal and decimal to binary. So binary number, any number, we will be taking 110 11. This is binary. We have to convert it into decimal to the base 10. Here we are denoting decimal as a base 10. So this we have to convert into base 10. So each and every representation we should calculate in this binary to decimal conversion. First of all, the power 1. Here the base is 2. So we should represent this number as 2 power 0, and this number 2 power 1. This will be 2 power 2, and this will be 2 power 3, and this will be 2 power 4. This is a representation of the binary to in the format of base 10, that means to the decimal one. So now we should calculate. How we should calculate? We should calculate like from right side corner. For the representation purpose, we should represent from the right side, but for the calculation purpose, we should calculate from the left side. So first, what will be this 1? Whatever the number we have assigned the power of 2, that 1 into 2 power 4 plus 1 into 2 power 3 plus 0 into 2 power 2 again plus here 1 into 2 power 1 again here 1 plus 1 into 2 power 0. I have to represent it based on this calculation. Now I will be calculate what I will be getting. 2 power 6. What is the power of 2 power 4? 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4. 2 to the 4, 2 to the 8, 2 to the 16. So 1 into 16 plus 1 into 2 power 8, 2 power 3, 8, 0. 0 into something will be 0. Plus 1 into 2 power 1 will be 2. Plus 2 power 0 means 1. 1 into 1 will be 1. So 16 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1. So calculate this. 16, 8 plus 2, 10. And 16 plus 10 plus 1. 26 plus 1 will be 27. To the base 10. This is a conversion from the binary to decimal. In this way, we are converting a binary number, which is as 1001 or as any binary number, we are converting into decimal with the base 10. In this way, we should calculate in this manner. Now, we check for decimal to binary. Here, the decimal base will be 10. The binary will be 2. Let us take any number. Like, I am taking here as 20. I am taking here 31. 31 to the base 10. I need to calculate into binary 3. Now, I should do, we all know division, right? So, we should follow the division method. Division method in this format. 2 1s are 2. 2 5s are 10. What will be the remaining number? The remaining will be 1. So, in the same way, 2 7s 14. So, 1 number is leaving. We are getting 1 number out. So 2, 3 are 6. Again we are getting 1 number out. We should write that 1 number beside it. Again 2, 1s are 2, 1. This way we have got these numbers. Now we should write from down to up. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To the base 2. So this is the conversion from binary to decimal to binary. So decimal number, any number which we are representing, we are saying it as a decimal number. So for that conversion, what we are doing? We are converting into binary number. How we are converting? Just by a rule of division method. By the division method, any division method. So we are dividing from binary to decimal and decimal to binary. The same way we check for decimal to octal and octal to decimal and decimal to hexadecimal. How how we can convert the decimal number into hexadecimal. So here hexadecimal is nothing but the base 16. So the decimal is nothing but the base 10. In the same way, here the decimal is to the base 10 and octal is to the base 8. So any decimal number just we'll take 374 to the base 10. We should convert this number to the base 8 number. So for the conversion of binary to octal, or is binary to decimal to binary, or decimal to hexadecimal, whatever the base here is there, we should follow a division process by that number, by 8. So we should check with the 8, the base 8. So in the 8, how 8 4s are 32, 8 5s are 40. So 8 4s are 32. So how much we are left 32, 33, 32, 33, 36, 37, 54. Then in the same way we should check. 8 6 are 48, 8 7 is 48, we should check. 48, 8 6 are 48. What is remaining? 6 is 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54. So 6 numbers we are leaving. So again 8. 8 5 is 40 we are getting. The left our number is 6. So in the same way we should calculate from the down. 5, 6, 6, the base 8. So in this way we should convert a decimal number into a octal number. So in the same way here, the decimal into hexadecimal. How we are converting a decimal number into hexadecimal? The same number or a second different number we'll take 2, 4, 7. This number we should calculate with the base 16. What is hexadecimal base is 16. By 16 we are dividing this number. So we will just check, we will take another digit for our easy calculation purpose. Just we will take 2. So for 16 here, we just will check 16 threes. What is 16 threes? 16 fours, 16 sevens, 16 sevens, 16 42, 7 7, 8 9, 10 11. So no, 16 eights we will check. 16 are 36, 16 are 46, 16 are 48, 11 are 8, 9 10 11, 11 are 8, 9 10 11 2. So we will check for 16 nines. 14. So we check for this number. Otherwise we can take directly like 16 ones 16. How many will be left in? 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. 8. Again we check for these two numbers. 16 sixes are 64. 16 sevens are 42. 7 7 8 9 10 11. No. So 16 sixes are we'll check. 16 fives will check. 30, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what is the number? 7. Again we check for 16 sixes. 36, 36, 7, 8, 9. Again this number only we will get. 16 fours will check. 6 fours are 24, 4 4, 5 6, 64 will get 4. What is the remaining? 64. 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 71, 72, 8 will be getting. So again we check for another thing. 16, 154. 16 9s, 9 6 are 54, 9 9 9, 10 12 12, 10 14, 144. So we will be getting 10. How about the 9s are? From down in the same way we should write 9 and 10 and 8. But here we are getting a 2 digit number. So here for hexadecimal, we already have discussed what is the number 10 we are representing. So here the number 10 we are representing as 8. So we should replace these number with the alphabet 8. So 9, 8, 8 to the base 16. So in this way we should convert a decimal number into hexadecimal, a decimal number into octal, a decimal into binary. In the same way, for decimal into binary, what we have done decimal to binary? To the base 10 number we have converted into the base 2. What we have done any number 37 we have divided with 2. So what is the leftover number? Just we have calculated. In the same way from down to up we have written in a bracket thing to the base 2. So this is decimal to binary, this is decimal to octal, and this is decimal to hexadecimal. So in the same way, whatever the base is available, to which base we are converting, with that base number we should do the LCM or the division thing. In this way we should calculate the calculation purpose. So in this way we are converting a four number system, the four different binary to these four number systems we are converting into each format to each format. Thank you.